Welcome back to ANC Presents. Mr. President, earlier we were talking about the case of former President Gloria Arroyo. I will just ask you, of course, to look ahead a little bit. Do you foresee a presidential pardon for her, just like she did with former President Estrada?
Yung pardon, I think, is governed by several policies within the Board of Pardons and Paroles. No?
Mm-hmm.
Yung degree of remorse is one component that I remember. Of course, at this point in time, they manifest that they are innocent of any of the charges.
Mm-hmm.
So if they still profess, mm-hmm. yeah, you know, where is the remorse? Where can we find the remorse there?
Mm-hmm. So it's something that will have to be
It's too seen. Way, way ahead,
mm-hmm. yeah, I think. Mm-hmm. Okay, let's go to the other person na medyo target din itong nakaraang mga araw, Chief Justice Renato Corona. What are your thoughts on this issue yung, between you and the former and the Chief Justice?
Can I just add to everything that I've said?
Mm-hmm.
I was shown a transcript of his speech. I think it was a flag raising ceremony. Mm-hmm. I had an interview kasi that day with Time Magazine.
Last week. Mm-hmm.
Then also several pronouncements by the court administrator. Can I center on the court administrator? Sabi niya, yung part of the impeachment complaint is yung filing of statement of assets, liabilities, and net worth. Okay. Then, I don't know if he was misquoted by the papers, no? Si Maidas Marquez, but he said, it's available to the public. All you have to do is ask, and if we approve, you'll get a copy.
Mm-hmm.
So parang pag binabasa ko lang kasi yung article in the Constitution, which is, I think, in public accountability, probably section 17.
Mm-hmm.
Yung may enumeration starting with me and ending up with generals and other flag officers, no, must declare their sal to the public in accordance with law.
Mm-hmm.
So parang, ganun ba interpretation yun to the public if you allow?
If you approve.
So, mm-hmm. Tapos kay Chief Justice also the same thing. No? Yung mm-hmm. the point about atat ako mag-appoint ng tatangan ko sa leg. Ano mga concept niya?
Mm-hmm.
I guess a lot of my thoughts centered on what they were pronouncing.
Mm-hmm.
And if they believe the things that they're saying, then it's really such a wide disparity between their concepts of what is embodied in the Constitution and what are mine and those and others.
Mm-hmm. See, Chief Justice Corona, is he really, shall we say, a target of the anti-corruption drive? Or is he like former Ombudsman Merceditas Gutierrez, some kind of an obstacle that has to be removed or replaced in order for you to go ahead?
We've tried. Yeah? Mm-hmm. We've tried to live with our dictates. Even if we didn't, in Congress, one of my colleagues kasi told me, and he was a lawyer, sabi niya, they're trained, wrong or right. They have to follow the Supreme Court because it's the final arbiter.
Mm-hmm.
The reasoning is if we don't, there'll be anarchy, etc., etc. The usual propaganda line that they've said. So, parang more and more, nandito'y question eh, are the laws there for man to serve
mm-hmm.
or are the laws put in place for it to serve man? And we'd like to think that the laws created by man were put in place to serve man and not the other way around.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Kasi dito pag, NCMF, I'll go on and on. Pero mm-hmm. bottom line, it has really, I was just shown something that I never thought I'd quote from him. You know?
Mm-hmm.
Si Senator Arturo Tolentino said in quite a long while back, no,
mm-hmm.
na kinakabahan siya doon sa autonomy, the growing power of the Supreme Court.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
There might come a point wherein it is no longer effectively being checked and balanced by the other two co-equal branches.
Mm-hmm. Do you see that now? Are we at a point where the autonomy and independence of the Supreme Court is growing too much such that they've become untouchable?
Yung point na parang wala na kaya in practice na nobody could review what they did or has reviewed what they did
mm-hmm.
was, I think, wrong.
Mm-hmm.
No. So, dapat, sa America, no, magkaroon ng Supreme Court ruling, then Congress enacts a new law to further define the intentions.
Mm-hmm.
No? Maski na na-reverse sila before that.
Mm-hmm.
But in this particular case, no, parang wala ka nag-challenge.
Mm-hmm.
Tama ba? Tama mm-hmm. ba yung perception na? And I think I made public naman the issues that we find disagreement with them.
Mm-hmm.
And, I think we're going through that step embodied in the Constitution, which resolves conflicts of mm-hmm. this nature.
Mm-hmm. Kanina you mentioned na you were accused of being atat na atat to put somebody there na natangan mo or somebody.
I think he proposed it as a question.
Oh. have you planned, let's say, in the event that Chief Justice Corona is impeached or is convicted in the Senate, or he resigns, just like in the case of Ombudsman Merceditas Gutierrez? Who would you like to see as his replacement?
Ah, wala pa tayo dun. But we, you know, I did remind my legal advisors, mm-hmm. kung sakasakali mangyari sitwasyon na yan, give me the short list already of people mm-hmm. that we can consider for that position.
Meron na bang mga nasa shortlist?
No, not yet. But we're concentrated on proving mm-hmm. the issues that were raised and mm-hmm. resolving the consequences of the wrong decisions we believe that they've executed.
Mm-hmm. Because if I remember it correctly, Ombudsman Gutierrez resigned just days before the trial began. And although doon sa kaso na yun, andun na si Justice Conchita Carpio Morales, no? It was kind of fast to institute the selection process.
There were several occasions that para after she retired, if I remember correctly. Mm-hmm. I'll talk to her. Point is to offer to somebody who will refuse the appointment.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Then I asked, you know, person just retired as an associate justice. Mm-hmm. Interesado pa ho ba kayo dito mas, para mas active? Mm-hmm. Kayong mag-iimbestiga? Kayong mm-hmm. bubungusa kung kani-kanino?
Let me ask you, Mr. President. Of course, there's a lot of talk, and even from the camp, I think, of the Chief Justice, that the one who might replace him would be one of the next senior Associate Justice, which is Justice Antonio Carpio. Is he in your shortlist?
Yeah, there's no shortlist yet. Let me reemphasize
that. No shortlist
that.
Yet. Oh.
But I can assure everybody that the criteria na di ba para sunod-sunod sa lahat ng gusto is not ano is not an operative thing. At bakit no? One of the earliest things I learned from my dad was yung he was quoting, I think it was a Russian author, yung he was talking about power corrupts and absolute power corrupts absolutely.
Mm-hmm.
So ako encourage all of my people to say, ito gusto kong gawin, tell me your opinions, good or bad, contra, supporta, etc. But after we make the decision, medyo isa na dapat ang tono natin dito.
Mm-hmm.
In the case of ano, ako equal branch, then you would want no, to strengthen the institution that can provide the check and balance down the line.
Mm-hmm.
And getting yung getting a lapdog no, is not and has never been part of the culture that exists in our family.
Mm-hmm. No. After Justice Carpio, the nine...
I'm not talking about Justice Carpio as a lapdog also, no? Just to
no,
make that
no.
clear.
Or the nine other justices. But of course, it also must be pointed out that yung nine justices na, in terms of seniority, eh, puro mga GMA appointees din. So, what I'm trying to say is that, are you open to getting somebody from the outside? Is that an option?
Yes. You know, at the end of the day, whoever I appoint, I will have to be able to look at anybody of our countrymen
mm-hmm.
and say, eto ang best.
Mm-mm. Mm-mm. No. Pagdating sa anti-corruption drive, ano pa ang gusto niyo makita? What will be your targets for our focus this coming year?
Siyempre, may convictions.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
No? Yung ngayon, baka medyo napapag-isip na sila kung may gagawin sila katiwalian dahil talaga hinahabol na namin. Pero pag na-convict mo at may napasok na sa kulungan, eh doon hindi na siguro nag-uumpisa mag-isip lang. Mm-hmm. Talagang magdadalawang isip na kung gagawin pa nila yung tiwali.
Mm-hmm. Meron ka bang mga naiisip na tao na, ay, ito na yung, you know, after GMA and then the impeachment of Chief Justice Corona, meron na ba kayong naka-next na? I don't want to call them targets, but...
Hindi mo habol na lahat na nagkasala mula sa panahon ni Edan at Eva ay masakdal.
Mm-hmm.
Pero habol mo naman na talagang yung mga hindi na nagbago mm-hmm. o nagpipilit para ipagpatuloy yung mali.
Mm-hmm.
Talaga mabigyan ng kaukulang kaparusahan.
Mm-hmm. Kanina, Mr. President, you're talking about your people, especially the people in the cabinet who came from the private sector, mga masisipag. And I remember a couple of weeks ago, you mentioned that there might be some changes in the cabinet, or at least in the top level management. Who would this be, and how soon do you think will you implement the changes?
There's some that are already known by the public, no? Pero I'll spare them the Christmas season and all the controversy, those who are outgoing and incoming, and I'll announce it at the proper time. Pero not major positions, but not necessarily in the cabinet.
They're not necessarily.
Or there might be movements within the cabinet to put we create a new position that helps me manage the entire cabinet, for instance, no? Or parang it's medyo na, not yet, we're not concentrated on that. We're still concentrated on all of these disasters, and more importantly, on we're front loading next year the budget. So I want everybody from January 2. Mm-hmm. January 1, saka na na. But in January 2, which is Monday, no, everybody has to hit the ground running. Na, may monthly kayong monitoring of everything kung pwede. Daily may monitoring kayo of everything that has to be accomplished. You'll be given the wherewithal to do on a semestral basis. So don't come back to me after 2 quarters and say, you're behind here and behind there. There has to be massive explanations of that. You also will concentrate. We just appointed, di ba? Governor Hataman, and when he used to have 2 years and some months, it's now down to 1.5 years that he has to produce the changes.
Do you think he can still, you know, accomplish what you and he set out to accomplish?
Matagal nang ginagawa yung roadmap. May electrification for ARM. Yung electrification kasi, the previous administration made it a point that high 90s barangays electrified. Tapos I'm told that in a sense, that's true. But the definition of an electrified barangay means there's a sitio in a particular barangay that has electricity.
Okay, a portion lang pala. Portion of
So, if I remember correctly, somewhere between 32 or 36,000 sitios have to be electrified. Medyo ang daming zeros. Pag, it's about 1 million per sitio. But the good news is, I'm told Binaya is way, way ahead of their schedule. And they're not going to ask for an additional expenditure for the initial commitment to me. So, the people will be watching your program soon. in the hinterlands, will appreciate that. Water systems also for ARM, road network, schools. But yung the 1.5 years will give the ARM government parang an opportunity to demonstrate how things can be better. Dahil from zero school to one school is majorly no road to concrete, barbed road. That's a certainty of electricity, better in potable water, etc., etc. But then the provision of the health workers and teachers and the like, no, it will really be felt, at even in the 1.5 years.
So you you mentioned that you wanted to see your cabinet and your other officials hit the ground running on January 2 of 2012. Does that mean that there won't be any changes during that period, so that to enable them to just continue with what they're doing
with the line agencies, no?
With the line agencies. Medyo kinakabahan na yata ang mga nakakarinig ngayon kung saan sila pupunta. But they've been told, whoever is going to be moved to one.
Yes.
Mr. President, can you say that you're happy with, let's say, your entire cabinet? You're happy with them in general?
In the current composition, yes.
What about your economic team?
Also.
Ito yung mga palaging nababanggit, economic team, legal team.
It's being improved also.
Being improved. Do we see additions and or subtractions?
You can say that.
Okay, communications group. I think
they're here and they're improving also.
No addition.
Tsaka meron yung mga consultants that we've asked. I try to be reasonable in the expectations. So we want to be transformative. And part of the transformative process is not to engage in what you consider the ills of the past dispensation, which means changing the rules of the game. So in the process, you measure the effectivity. I constrained them not to perpetuate that wrong system. Therefore, I have to be reasonable in the expectations of what they can achieve in the transition period from that system to the new.
Then let's look ahead, of course, 2012. What are your plans, legislative agenda, economic agenda for the coming year?
It's a legislative agenda. Let me try to remember all of them. No? Yung sa AMLAC, parang toothless, that has to be re-engineered. Syntaxes, yung napakaraming bases. There has to be rationalization of the entire structure with regards to syntaxes, and in view of getting more revenue for government, and level the playing field also. Yung maritime boundaries is such an important thing, especially given the disputes of West Philippine Sea. Also the potentials for cooperation for border patrolling between us and our neighboring countries. There's so many in that agenda, but those three come to mind first.
Mm. I think people are also would like to know how soon will you push the freedom of information bill?
We've been working at it. Because even in the consultations with the stakeholders, but they can come up with an agreement. Kanya-kanya nuance. And all I'm saying is, let us make something that is livable by everybody. Yung katulad na, no? Yung first, what was this? Iligan ng Cagayan, may suspected na dikes, temporary dikes that gave way, that increased the water flow tremendously, that led to this disaster. Mm-hmm. So, nagpadala ng fact-finding team yung DPWH and they reported that that wasn't the case. But if there was a memo and said, sir, we suspect ganyan-ganyan, Freedom of Information says, you got a report, can you have a copy? Mm-hmm. O di panic na lahat ng tao doon ngayon.
So you want to make sure that the measures are in place so that there will be no abuse or irresponsible use of the information?
Even people from your industry tell us, kung masipag kayo, don't need it. The transparency provisions are all there. But at the same time, there are certain quarters say, we trust you, but what about the person
in
that
the
comes after you?
In the future.
But don't make... We have to really balance all of the issues. Kunyari, meron kaming cabinet meeting. May magsasabi ng some piece of information na hindi pa pwede sa korte. Pero pwede niya sabihin doon, dahil this is a secret meeting. Tayo lang, and this has to be part of the considerations. The other day, may nagre-report sa akin about certain personalities sa security aspect. Pag ginawa mo formal report yun, can we have that? Tapos sabi na, the exemption naman yung national security concerns. And then that forces me to declare everything part of the national security area of concern. Hindi naman yata okay rin yun. You know, even in America, which has the very good Freedom of Information Bill, I'm told that there's still a retention of the right to start para censoring the material that you raise. And you have to be very specific about what you're looking
what
for.
What you want.
So, I hope, no? I'll ask this committee that's been talking to all of the stakeholders, can we move faster on it also?
On resolving all these issues. Well, of course, and then we mentioned that looking ahead to 2012, although 2013 is the election year, we expect some political posturings and alignments this year. You are, of course, the head of the Liberal Party.
Chairman, Mr. President.
The chairman of the chairman of the Liberal Party. But of course, they will be looking to you for guidance and some directives. What will be LP's alliances for the coming year? And with 2013 in mind?
I think it will be the party president who will have to say that. It is the party president who is empowered by our party's constitution to decide that. But yung ang dami naman dinemonstrate ito mga allies natin, especially in the House, no? That they have been adhering to the agenda.
Except for one or two who have left already.
One of the two I think that you're referring to, I was shown the voting record and it's been consistently against our positions, although part of the majority coalition. So we actually were surprised because he publicly keeps saying the same lines that we are, but in practice, he was voting against the things that he was espousing. This is democracy. You can join whatever group you want.
Nagbubuo na ba kayo ng senatorial ticket for 2013?
I'm on the periphery of it. Kasi parang pero sa problema ng bansa natin, ang dami pa rin natin talaga dynamics sa world. You know? West Philippine Sea, global economy, unrest in the Middle East, and so on and so forth. I'm called in every now and then, but we haven't gotten to the stage of yung setting up the mechanisms for yung sirwa common candidates and all of that.
I ask because probably ikaw lang ang presidente, kayo lang ang presidente siguro na hindi masyadong, given that you have so many things on your plate, even in the past, presidents usually talaga get involved. Let's say, in coming up with the administration senatorial ticket. So, what do you see will be your role there?
I'm sure I'll be there to referee. No? But more than anything, siguro at the end of the day, naasahan ko parating taong bayan. No? So, tayo iikot mga kampanya ng 2013, So sila papakiusapan ko, tulungan naman niyo ako, huwag niyo akong bigyan ng pabigat. Bigyan naman niyo ako ng tutulong dito kung palagay niyo tama yung direksyon ginagawa natin.
Mm. Do you have one or two or a couple of names in mind who you feel should be running, or at least in the ticket?
I did broach. There are several actually in my mind right now.
You can mention several.
Never, I'll be disappointed siguro, for instance, if Risa Tiberias Barakel would not participate in it.
Mm-hmm.
Si Rufy Biasan is another one. No? Then there are others that I'm convincing. Sunny Trillanes is also, you know, parang, probably Danny Lim also will be part of it. In addition, tapos yung others na have come from there or from a very purely political background.
Mm-hmm.
Siguro hindi ko na muna nga makapagsalita yung, I've said already before, that's the third of the whole slate. And we're supposed to foster the interests of the nation as a whole.
Mm-hmm.
We have such a broad coalition. We'd like to say that they're all equal partners.
Are we seeing, just a final question on this, are we seeing some of your cabinet secretaries leaving to cast their, you know?
In all honesty, they haven't told me.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
They have, except for one, si Butchabad yata. Si Butchabad, I thought, would be one of the candidates.
Mm-hmm.
Then the last time, he said, parang nagbago na yata isip niya. Lalo na sinabi ko, parang campaign manager kita for two runs, the Senate and the presidency.
Mm-hmm.
Para naman makabawi ako sa'yo. Ako naman ang campaign manager mo. Mm-hmm. Bibigyan rin kita parehong schedule na binigay mo sa akin. Pero hindi 20 engagements mo in a 24-hour period. Gawin natin 22. In a 24-hour period.
But
he was saying, I think it's very effective the cabinet right now.
Mm-hmm.
It's very happy, it's our party ideology. Yung when I need to send a message to somebody to explain it in a parang a soft sell approach, which is the normally go-to guy.
Mm-hmm.
But if he runs for the Senate, I think he'll be a good senator.
Mm-hmm. Do you see, we were talking to Secretary Llamas a couple of weeks ago, and he was saying that,
Secretary Llamas will not run.
Now, he was planning for a big tent. Parang sinasabi niya that, you know, the administration might have a big tent of coalition partners to come up with a common ticket. But also, we are hearing from the camp of Vice President Binay that they might come up with their own ticket. Do you see Vice President Binay's group joining the admin big tent?
That might be difficult. I talked to all of them. I am sure I will talk to each one and propose that idea.
Mm-hmm.
And to all the members of the coalition. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
But at the end of the day, I will not force anybody. You know, I will strive for a consensus. And those of like mind will be together. And those who are not, they will look for the others of like mind.
Mm-hmm. Why do you think it will be difficult? Because of the, feelings of some?
Yeah, 2030. Parang everybody will agree to the concept of we should have one candidate.
Mm-hmm.
Then when it comes to which candidate, other than disagreement.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Medyo may konti pa bang samaan ng loob yung mga grupo na involved in 2010?
I don't think it's samaan ng loob. No? But syempre, you have to prepare for a bruising battle in 2016.
Mm-hmm.
How many candidates will there be once 2016 comes in? And you have to really broad differentiate and be the front runner and all of that.
Are you looking at 2016 already in terms of...
Retirement, yes.
Retirement, I'm sure. But anointing a successor?
Hopefully. Di ba, I was asked, I had a meeting with a whole number of Protestant... pastors, bishops, no?
Mm-hmm.
And there were at least two of them who asked, yung sa lahat ng ginagawa nyo ngayon, pagbaba nyo, paano natin masisigurado magpapatuloy? Then the other one says, meron na ho ba susunod sa inyo? So, I responded in this manner. Kaya asan nyo sa akin lahat? Di wala naman talaga mangyayari sa atin. Mangyayari na mangyayari. Maski gano'n ako ka-health conscious, tatawagin tayo ni Lord at some point in time.
Mm-hmm.
No? So it has to be a collective effort. So I have to recall when was the last time I woke up gradually.
Mm-hmm.
So
you woke up gradually. What does that mean?
from dead asleep to wide awake in 5 seconds or less.
Mm-hmm,
kasi pagbangon mo talaga, automatic, buksan mo na yung telepono mo, mababasa mo lahat ng text, daanan mo dalawa dyan, daanan mo yung news cups.
Mm-hmm.
I have to admit, ako nanood ng TV, medyo it's early morning.
It's okay.
Basta, sana sabay-sabay yan, mm-hmm. tapos kilos na kung whatever has mm-hmm. to be done.
Mm-hmm.
Matutulog ka, you get reports, especially yung situation for the Philippines, or yung mga developments outside the country, lalo mm-hmm. pag umaga sa outside of the country.
Mm-hmm.
Ito, Pasko, di ba? Para nag-iisip tayo lahat. Kasama ko yung mga pamangkin ko, tsaka kapatid ko si Chris. Mm-hmm. Naliwa ko doon kay Joshua doon with mm-hmm. the street children.
Mm-hmm.
Unang bati sa akin, yung Bulusan Volcano.
Mm-hmm.
No? Yung madadagdagan yung mga lugar na masasalantaro na ulan.
Mm-hmm.
May danger na flash floods, mm-hmm. tsaka landslides. Yung pag may piracy problem sa Somali, di ba? Parang... Mm-hmm. Yun yung hindi pwedeng appreciate nature effect. Look, wow, nice sun, yung ba ganun, or may birds.
Stop and smell the flowers.
Wala ganun.
Well, you will have that after 2016 because, so, you know.
But trigger the point is, para all of this is if we are able to really transform the country, mm-hmm. sulit.
Mm-hmm.
Ngayon, kung na-transform namin, tapos July 1, balik backslide. Mm-hmm. Naman.
Mm-hmm.
So, syempre, yun ang target that we will be successful in training our successor. And the successor is an inheritor of something that so good that people are so used to that system that there's no possibility of backsliding.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Well, later on, you know, Mr. President, before we came to this interview, we asked also some of the people to send us questions sure. on ANC via Twitter and Facebook. We'll just have to take a short break again, and then after that, we'll go to their questions. Please stay tuned. This is ANC Presents The President. We'll be right back.